The purpose of a Gantt chart is to plan and control a project. With both detailed measures and this intuitive graphic timeline, we find that our clients most commonly use their Gantt chart template for lean process improvement and Six Sigma quality improvement projects. But being written in Excel, it's easy to add columns or make other small changes to personalize this flexible template to manage any type of project. Maybe you want to plan a facilities move or a new product introduction, or maybe just plan a holiday party. The design philosophy behind the Systems to Win Excel Gantt chart is to provide more than 80% of the benefits of traditional project management software for less than 20% of the price. Although there have been many improvements to the Gantt chart over the last few years, this video will illustrate those features that have not changed. If you are using an older version of the Gantt chart, it's really important to follow those detailed instructions to define your project start date before you even get started. On the new version, it's pretty much a no-brainer. The single most important thing to remember when using a Systems to Win Gantt chart is do not insert blank rows. Instead, you want to copy empty blank rows that contain the formatting and formulas that you need. And you use Shift down and copy to do that, and we give you a separate training video on how to do it. You should be familiar with that by now. You do it on every Excel spreadsheet that you use. And of course, that's also the right way to move rows. The first three columns are pretty self-explanatory, so let's focus our attention on the calculations. In these next columns, we start getting into numbers. And this first one is of terrific interest to most project managers, because it gives them something they want but can't get from even their more expensive project management software. Most project management software deals only with duration, which in the language of Lean would be called lead time. Duration is usually measured in days, although our template allows you to use any unit of measure, and answers the question, how many days will it take before this task or phase or project is finished? Let's just pretend for a moment that the answer is 14 days. What's missing in most project management software is the answer to the question, during those 14 days, how many hours of effort will be required of my people? How many billable hours for my expensive consultants? How many precious hours from my already overloaded project manager? How many hours of effort from each of my team members? Those are the questions that are answered by this first column called effort. See at the top where it says subtotal effort and subtotal duration? As of this moment, we're seeing the totals for the entire project. But see those little drop-down arrows on each column heading? We can use those to filter our data. Let's say that we want to see the effort for just our project manager. There you go. Or we can filter for our top 10, or for blanks, or for non-blanks. Or we can use this custom filter for more sophisticated filtering with and/or statements and the Boolean operators that you see here, like equals, begins with, or does not contain. Or we can select all and see everything again. And notice that those subtotals are not just for effort and duration, but also for money. And you can also use this same power for any user-defined columns that you dream up. Are you starting to see the advantages of using Excel? This feature is called auto-filter. And again, you're not learning to use some third-party proprietary software that you'll never see again. You're learning to get more value from the software you already own, Excel. And you can use what you learn with any other worksheet for anything else you do or might do with Excel. The next two columns are for start date and end date. Again, it's just Excel, so you can use format, cells, number to choose any date format that you like. And you can even choose to measure time in hours rather than days if you're working with projects of very short duration. See how some cells have a gray background? That's because those cells contain formulas. If you've ever accidentally deleted your formulas, you will appreciate that Systems to Win has provided this special function to easily identify cells containing formulas. By the way, here's a useful tip. If you ever accidentally delete one of our default formulas, you can usually simply copy and paste the same formula from a similar cell in another row. As you can see by the gray cells on the blank worksheet, the default is to calculate the end date. So if we enter a start date of 1107 and a duration of 2 days, it auto-calculates our end date. So let's enter another task with a duration of 1 day, and this time let's make the start date a formula. Let's say that the start date for this task starts 2 days after the end date for the previous task. See how the cell background turned gray to show us that our start date is now also a formula? Let's do that again. Let's enter another task. And this time, let's make the start date equal to the start date of the first task plus 7 days. You have all the power of Excel calculations to define predecessor relationships like this. So what if you want to enter the end date and calculate only the start date? Or what if you want to calculate duration instead of start date or end date? Then you simply follow the instructions on this help text box on the sample help page and delete the default end date calculation so that there is no cyclical formula reference, and then copy one of these two predefined formula cells found on your sample help page. In this case, we want to copy the duration and then paste that formula in the duration cell for that row. And there you go. Now this row calculates duration instead of end date. It's that easy. And remember, you can always replay anything that you don't catch the first time. Once you start actually using your Gantt chart, it won't be long before your first weekend rolls around. And you start pulling your chin about how to take your work calendar into consideration. For example, maybe you're planning to work some weekends and not others. Now, one of the big advantages of full-featured project management software is that they allow you to define a sophisticated shop calendar with all your work days and holidays precisely defined. We can't do that. And frankly, any seasoned project manager knows that most project plans simply aren't that precise anyway. What we can do is give you a pretty good approximation. And the DV worksheet contains very clear instructions for how to use your work calendar adjustment codes. So what if we have a milestone date that has to be absolutely fixed? That's as easy as just typing in that fixed date and then scheduling backward or forward around it. Can you see how this works? If not, you can always replay this until it makes sense to you and you start to see just how powerful this can be. And like every other Systems to Win Excel template, you can add text boxes and callouts and lightning bursts and circles to call attention to things and make your deliverables far more communicative, effective, and professional. Well, as long as you don't overdo it. Just like any other Excel worksheet, you can hide and unhide the columns and rows to show only what you want to show. And you just resize this column to resize the chart. Notice that if we just click File Print, it prints all the columns as well as the chart. But notice this, if we select the chart before we print, then it prints only the chart. This is where it can be very nice to choose the radio button that shows the labels on the chart. So there are a lot of advantages of the Systems to Win Gantt chart, not the least of which is the training video that you're watching right now, which combined with the fact that it's written in Excel results in a radically reduced learning curve. And that learning curve gets leverage with all the other Excel tools that can come bundled with your Gantt chart. Once your people learn one, they've learned to use them all. And the System's Win Gantt chart overcomes the number one complaint of users of Microsoft Project and other expensive Gantt chart software. It's inexpensive enough that maybe your management could spring for a copy for everyone on your project team.